All right. Welcome back. It's the winner's match, and it's time to see which of these players will be the first one out of the North American group and the first one into the round of eight for the fight before Christmas. I'm Rifkin Caster tonight with ZombieGrop. I hope you've enjoyed the show so far, as we have one more best of three after this one. But spawning here in the bottom left corner of the map on Nimbus, it's going to be Mindsanity's Pink Zerg player, Kane.
The bottom right, as the Blue Terran, it's CM Storm's Polt.
So this was kind of cool to have Polt actually play in this. I know we've requested his presence for previous tournaments, but the case is he's usually been busy or traveling for Red Bull or WCS or just not actually been available. I guess with the tournaments for the year starting to come to a conclusion, and I think IEM Taipei, the only thing really coming up in the grand scheme of things, he had some time free. I was really happy he was able to come play. And of course, I know CM Storm is particularly happy about this. They've been sponsoring our tournaments for quite some time. We haven't had any other players in it other than Revival, but that wasn't even for the one they were sponsoring. So big love again to CM Storm for continuing to support us. Again, we don't have any giveaways for you guys yet today, but we will over the course of the rest of the tournament. We'll have some cool stuff to raffle off on each of these broadcasts. And of course, some of that stuff's going to be provided by CM Storm, which is pretty rad.
I was a little hesitant to introduce CM Storm Polt as CM Storm Polt. He has not been playing like we would usually expect. At least not two times in a row, at least for me. Maybe one crazy build, but not two times in a row, and that's what he did. I don't know if he just like did no move skills and was like, let's have some fun, or the maps lined up really nicely to do that, or what, but a little more normal, I guess. 14 CC on Nimbus. It's legit.
It's Nimbus. You kind of expect this. There's some players out there, like, I'm thinking back to, like, J-Dong, like, when we saw him play Nimbus in the previous tournament. Like, they'll go for the early aggression, expecting you to do precisely this. But, I mean, an earlier CC is hardly a risky build, even if it's a CC first.
Yeah. Nimbus can be good for Baneling all-ins. We've seen at least two that were super effective. I mean, like, really, they would scout it maybe 10 seconds in advance and have, like, no idea what to do. Because where do you place the bunker? They just run past it once they break down the wall.
Yeah.
It's a hard hold, but it is also too risky. We rarely see the actual Baneling busts. I mean, Baneling busts as a whole have kind of gotten, you either add roaches in it or you know, it's a no muta, no upgrade Baneling bust on three base mid game.
Yeah, I mean, like, seriously, when we saw the WCS finals, that blew my mind, because it's been a long time since we've seen just, like, raw Baneling all-ins. But I just want to know, this is kind of crazy for me personally. As good of a player as Polt is and fantastic as he is, going through the bets here, I'll read them all out a little bit later in the series, guys. Kane actually has the favoritism through the crowd as far as Partoofs go.
Really?
Yeah.
Guys, did you not see, I mean, Moose Kills?
Moose Kill is more like Moose Killed.
Yeah, I was going to say get wrecked, and then you made a funnier pun. but seriously, like, I'll just credit the guy, but like that first game actually went so well. I bet he's sort of like, man, I've really held my own against Polt, and that second game was like, oh, no, damn. I'm really surprised by you guys. We have a little bit of a build coming out, too. Again, two base. This is a... Which variation of this? There's so many two base builds, like variations. The thing is that they've kind of fallen out of favor for like two base Hellbat variation builds. Banshee Hellbat, Marine Hellbat, Hellion Hellbat, like whatever. The bio, the stim only no combat shields, the plus one no combat shield, like that, it's all kind of like fallen out of favor, but Polt's using it now.
Well, I just want to clarify something here. It was brought up in chat. So folks don't actually know, the prize pool was originally announced to be $2,000. We've managed to bump it up to $4,000. Now it's $2,000 for first place in this tournament. Just by making it to the round of eight, you get $50, which isn't maybe the craziest amount in the world, but it's the same as winning like a go for StarCraft or half of a Zotac. So just by getting far enough in this tournament, you'll make some money, and of course, there's big bucks for first place.
Yeah. So I guess this is the variation that doesn't have any medivacs in it. I guess you can still flip Starport now. We'll see.
It's a lot of production early on, and it's what kind of crazy is the second tech lab. I mean, I guess if you're looking to pump out combat shields, this makes a little bit more sense. But I mean, really, Polt is that guy who's done Marauder pushes in the past, right? I mean, all the way back to the days of like MLG versus Hyun. I mean, Not too crazy for someone like Polt, but I'd say crazy if it was just like a random Joshimo Terran player.
Yeah. I mean, if it's going to be a medevac list, it's going to be hard to do anything with it, and it won't last very long. You know, if you do that medevac with the Helena 6 Marines and it gets shut down, the very least you can do is pick up the Marines and continue harassing, and then that's still actually pretty good. You can still do a lot of damage off of it. With something without medevacs, you're kind of just saying, like, well, I hope this wins and doesn't get absolutely crushed, because then I got a really good fallback plan.
Yeah, and let's talk about why this is such a scary build too for a moment. I mean, unless Kane's doing two base Mutalisks, you can't really counter this with just Roaches. The Marauders are here with Stim to make up for that. You can't counter it with just Banelings. The Marauders are there again with Stim to make up for that. These units add a lot more to the fight, but of course the biggest weakness here is that if there are Mutas coming out early, it's a little bit harder to deal with.
This Overlord, I think he's gonna scout it. Oh, move the army, move the army. Move the army. Okay, move the army. Even still, was that enough? Three barracks? Two tech labs might be a little suspicious, maybe?
I think the two tech labs have got to raise a big red flag that at least something's coming. He might not know it's Marauders for sure, but he's got to know it's something, because why would you get combat shields this soon? Why would you have anything? Because he sees it researching. So Banling's on the way immediately. Good choice here out of Kane, but is it enough? 26 Lings are falling in this. If he can get rid of the Hellions, these Zerglings will do work.
Yeah, now he definitely knows what's up. Scan goes down, more Banelings morph. I mean, those initial Banelings are like, well, this will defend against most things. And now he realizes he's going to need a lot. He's also going to need maybe a lucky surround on these Hellions. Otherwise, Pulse Control will take out some of these Banelings. No, they all hit Marines.
I got a little bit splash on the Marauders, which isn't horrible, but the Hellion count is still quite large. Trying to fall back away from the Banelings, he can kite this away. And this is, again, the danger of those Marauders.
If you can get rid of all these Banelings, the Marauders are going to take out the Queens. A couple more transfuses go down. Maybe not.
He's definitely, it might have been a cooldown. He's definitely got the energy for it, but putting up a good fight, but still, Polt's just rallying across the map. That's a really pressure build, and I mean, he's got armor upgrades coming up on his plus ones finish. He's still making SCVs, make no mistake. For Polt, like, this is him just starting to snowball really out of control.
It looks like it. Kane's starting to lose out on those injects. He is reducing the Queens. He's got to use money, and he needs the injects. They're good for multiple things, but it looks like he's kind of running out of steam. He has no time to build any more Banelings.
Oh, the drones are stacking up to retreat. This lines up for the Hellions. Line them up! Line them up! 13 drones died.
Wow, and you know, Pulse has to be on even upgrades. All off the back of one engineering bay.
Yeah, the Banelings, I don't know if they can really... I mean, for Kane, he loses his third. This is more about losing an advantage than being devastated out of the game just yet. But he's still not in a really good spot to stay in the game much longer after the hatchery goes down. I mean, still lots of Hellions, lots of Marauders, but they're all badly injured. And one or two good Baneling connections, some Queen focus fire, it might just be what he needs to stay in this game. Spinecaller's on the way, but this is should have been started a long time ago.
Oh, third command center. Starport did finish up as well, so you got a couple of medevacs up here. And this is like, this is almost with the medevacs. I don't see him winning at all. Even without the medevacs, I actually thought that
Kane's still trying to
spread a little bit.
He's still trying to get mutas. He hasn't given up hope just yet. Banelings get some decent connects here on the ramp, but can't quite reach those Hellions, a little too fast. Marauders are starting to get picked up and picked off, but.
Keep going. Hellions get a little bit of a surround here. A couple of them do finally go down.
That was like half and more. Like, there's only three Hellions remaining. Still a very dangerous force, but Kane's lost all of his mobile army. The spy cars might be able to fight this, but at the same time, Polk could just go to the natural. Lift up and go.
Yeah. You see all the production that was kind of lagging behind. Five barracks go down.
And a third command center. I think that's what I'm focused a little more on. This third CC is going to give Polk a big edge in this game. For Kane's sake, all those workers lost. Again, this kind of just knocks him down to the same level as Polt's, minus mules.
I've seen Polt do this build, and it gets the third, and he can bounce off it really quickly, and he'll throw down like the five racks, the armory, the engineering bay, the starport, all at the same time. It's just like, oh, how is this a like productive build? But it is. And it's one, but Polt with the legs. Just mix it in every once in a while.
Well, we got some shoutouts to get caught up, my guys. I want to let you know we have seen the donations, but there hasn't really been a moment of breathing in this game. Lings do get past Polt's depots being down. You know, we might have five racks of production, but not if the Lings are going to be camping on top of them. Marines getting picked off here. SCV's not really being pulled into the fight just yet. In fact, just being pulled away to keep them alive. Not a bad choice either.
Yeah.
It's like a traffic jam over there.
Going to the command center was probably a little bold.
But this was such a good move out of Kane to actually force everything back home. He was definitely not having a great time playing super defensive the way he was. Some SCVs are now exposed here towards the third. There's Marines out, sure, but again, everything Kane does, Russell's pulls Jimmy's just a little bit and gets him back into the game slightly. In fact, big Baneling attack coming. 10 more on the way. But these Widow Mines now. Gotta be careful with this.
I like the idea. I mean, he comes with the Lings, he comes with the Mutas. That could have surprised Polt even more. And now he comes with the Banelings. This could be a huge surprise, but there's such a big army for Polt. Even if they got, like, good connections, I don't think it would be enough. Those weren't the worst, but, you know, spreading's pretty good.
I think it's just a very anticlimactic loss there for Kane. It just fell apart a little too much. Definitely start with that third going down, but